.NET standard library, because right now the thing is we have the three extension of our .NET. Like we have .NET Framework 4.5, we have .NET Core 2.1. Now we have here Xamarin as well. But now the requirement is like how we can share the code across these three implementation. For the code sharing, we have here .NET standard library. So using the .NET standard library, we can share the code among all these three version, or you can say all these three, the implementation of .NET. So just create a .NET standard library and you can use it with Xamarin project, .NET core project, and the .NET framework project here. And then do the things. Let me show the way how we can share the code here. If you will open the Visual Studio and if you will create a solution here. So what I'm doing here, I'm just creating a new solution here. And in that solution, I will create a .NET 4.5 base application and a .NET core base application here. So what I'm doing here, I'm just creating a new project. So what I'm doing, I have created the new project. So what I'm doing here, I'm just creating a Visual Studio blank solution. And let me specify the location. So location is here, let's say desktop. What I'm doing here, I'm just defining the solution name, let's say code sharing. We are just going to do here between the various implementation of .NET. So what I'm doing here, let me create here a MVC 5 project. So I'm creating here a MVC 5 project like a web. And this is the option here for ASP.NET MVC 5. So I'm just defining the name as MVC 5. And guys, here in the .NET standard, we have the various version for .NET standard, if you will see. So if you want to use a .NET standard 2.1, so the minimum version for the .NET framework should be here 4.6.1. So make sure when you are creating the .NET framework based application, it should target at least 4.6.1. Don't use 4.5. If you will use here 4.5, you can use here the .NET standard 1.1. I cannot use 1.2, 1.3, I like 2.0. So I'm planning to use here 2.0. So that's why when I will create MVC 5 application, I will use here 4.6.1. This is a minimum requirement here as per this diagram I have shared to you. So make sure you have selected here 4.6.1 and you will get the 4.6.1 here in this drop down list. When you will download the .NET framework 4.6 and the 4.7 separately. So I have downloaded the 4.7 separately. That's why I'm getting it. Otherwise, I will not get it. Same way on your machine, you have to download these versions separately. So I'm just using here 4.6.1, then OK. So it will create the MVC 5 application targeting 4.6.1 here. So I'm just using here the internet template. So it's creating the MVC 5 project and it's tried to add in my Visual Studio. So as you will see here, it's created the MVC 5 project here successfully. Now let me create the ASP.NET Core application. So I'm creating the ASP.NET Core web application now. So specify your application name, let's say web app core. And here also I will create the MVC base project. So this is the framework here I'm just using here. ASP.NET Core 2.1. And this is here for targeting our framework, like either target .NET Core, either target .NET Framework. So here, what I'm doing, I'm just targeting here .NET Core. So just use here .NET Core and then select here the web application using the MVC pattern. So I will explain all these templates later on, because my focus is now about the code sharing between these two applications. So here, if you will see, we have the ASP.NET Core application having the controller. This is the MVC 5 application. And if you will look into the architecture, like folder structure in both these applications, there are so many differences here. If you will see in the ASP.NET Core, we don't have the web.config file. We don't have the packages.config. We don't have so many things here. Now the requirement is for code sharing between these two application here. So how I can share the code? I'm creating here one more project. Let's say I'm creating a project here using the C#. So make sure when you're creating the class library, use the .NET standard. .NET standard is here for code sharing. .NET framework is only for the .NET framework 4.5. And here we have for .NET Core as well. So this is the class library only for .NET Core. So what we have to do here, don't create the class library targeting the .NET Core or .NET framework. Just create a class library targeting the .NET standard here. Now just define the library name. Let's say we want to put some models like domain models in our application, which we want to share between these two types of application. So I have used here the domain models. Now in the domain models, I will put some classes. So let's say I'm creating here a user class. That user class I will share between the MVC5 application and between the ASP.NET Core application. Let's say name. And for accessing this one, just add the reference of domain models here. Domain models. Same, I can access in my ASP.NET Core application as well. Add reference of domain models here. Then for the class one, I can mention here user this way. Now what you can do, you can build the solution now. If everything is perfect, it should be built now. So you can see here it's building the things here. So you can see here it has been built successfully. There is no issue here. So this is the style which we can use for code sharing between the different the version, or you can say the different implementation of .NET based application. So same .NET standard library we can access in Xamarin as well. If I will add a Xamarin project for Android, iOS, I like for targeting all. So I can do here code sharing for this Xamarin based application as well.